Hello friends, welcome to edupediaworld.com. In today's video, we will discuss about the factors that affect the environment, and specifically we will discuss about industrialization and synthetic material. How industrialization is having an impact on the environment, how is it affecting the environment in positive way as well as in the negative way, and also what other factors will be affecting the environment with respect to the synthetic material, right? So let's first talk about industrialization. Now, when we talk about India, our country, India is predominantly an agricultural country, and industrialization offers gain in efficiency that affected almost every facets of life in society, right? Now, industrialization increased agriculture as well as the manufacture output in our country, and it allowed people to take a lot of jobs in the other sectors, and increasingly the amount of, you know, consumer goods and food available to the population. So basically what industrialization did to our country is that it created a significant increase in the availability of food and the resources and also the availability of the jobs, right? Why was it required? See, as the population increased, as well as increase in the economic output also, so spurred technological development, enabling scientific advances that changed the entire world, right? And also it changed the economy of our country also. But growth and the pattern of industrialization in India is such that it had some positive as well as some negative impact on the environment and in fact on the population in this country, right? And we are going to talk about those positive and negative impacts on the environment and also on the people that are living in the country, right? So let's move ahead. So what is industrialization? Industrialization is that period of social and economic changes that transforms a human group into an industrial one, involving the extensive reorganization of an economy for the purpose of manufacturing. What does that mean? That means, you know, there are new industrial methods which came up. There are new technology which came into existence, which had transformed the economy of our country. And how did it do so? You know, by allowing people to acquire more and more jobs, by allowing people and the farmers to use the modern technology and to produce more food and to allow more production in order to fulfill the needs of the growing population, right? So that is what is industrialization. So now we'll talk about the benefits of industrialization, and first we will discuss the low cost of production. Because of industrialization, the cost of production had come down. Why did it come down? Basically because, you know, when the sophisticated technology came in, the machines were highly sophisticated. So because of these high value machinery, the requirement of number of the laborers also decreased. One single machine could do a job of, let's say, 100 people. So that's why we did not require so many people. And so we didn't have to pay those many people the salaries, like the wages. So that's how the cost of production came down. And the introduction of the industries, you know, have led to the decrease in the cost of production of many essential items. The decrease in the cost is the result of economy of large scale production. It allows to save time and labor, and that's why industrial goods have become more affordable for common person also. As it was well said by Wendell Berry, the aim of industrialization had always been to replace people with machine or with the other technology, to make the cost of production as low as possible, to sell the product as high as possible, and to move the wealth into fewer and fewer hands, right? So this quote actually explains why was the production of the cost of production was so low. This is a very, very apt quote to explain to you how industrialization could get the cost of production down to so low price. Next is a self-sufficiency. Now, before independence, we used to spend hundreds of millions of rupees over import of clothes only, just the clothes, as we had no heavy industries in the real sense of the term. With the advancement of our textile industry into our country, we are now able to manufacture clothes at a much lower cost. And in this way, we made ourselves self-sufficient in providing our basic needs, in fulfilling our basic needs. So that's why we became self-sufficient. Next important impact, which is a positive impact of industrialization, is the employment opportunities. We had large number of industries. They employed skilled and semi-skilled workers, and they provided massive employment opportunities to the large chunk of people, right? So if you remember, I said in the first point that one machine can do a job of 100 people. And on the other hand, now I'm saying that, you know, it provided employment opportunity. Yes, you know, both the points are true. When these sophisticated machines came into use, then there was no more requirement of so many people to be doing the same work. But then, on the other hand, to operate those sophisticated machines, we wanted skilled people. And we wanted semi-skilled and skilled people to operate these machines. So on the other hand, there were employment opportunities which were provided to these workers, right? Okay, next is improved agriculture. Now in the modern age, efficient agriculture system is that which is done with the help of machines and mechanical devices, right? And these machines and mechanical devices are really high-end devices. They are very sophisticated devices and they are very efficient also. For this purpose, we have to adopt the latest industrial system, and this led to production of good quality and more quantity. Good quality of crop and food and other fruits and vegetables, and also in large quantity. Because we must keep pace with the march of the time, so we have to defend our country against any foreign aggression if it happens in the future. So we must manufacture latest weapons. So it is very, very important for us to not depend on any foreign or any other neighboring country for these weapons, but we have to be self-sufficient as far as our defense and security is concerned. So industrialization helped us in getting ourselves, our defense forces and our security forces equipped with the latest weapons and latest technology in order to fight such a situation, right? Now, till now, we have talked about all the positive impact of industrialization, which helped our economy to grow, which helped our country to develop in a lot many fields. But then with this industrialization, as the industrialization came in, the globalization also stepped in. There are many negative impacts of this industrialization, which affected our environment in a very, very negative way. So we are going to now talk about some of those negative impacts of industrialization. Mainly these impacts are on environment, are on people, and it is on the health of people. So let's talk about some negative impacts. So first is the decline of cottage industry. Heavy and large scale industries have negative impact, which adversely affects the environment, society, and also the economy of our country. But as far as the cottage industry is concerned, throughout, since independence, India has been proud of her rural cottage industries. The silk that is provided by the village weavers had been a source of attraction over the world. But with the advent of heavy mechanical industries, there began a chapter of the decline of our village cottage industries. Next is mass immigration from rural areas. Another attack is that with the creation of heavy mechanized industries in the urban areas, the rural population would start, you know, massive immigration into the towns and the cities. and thereby making the unemployment problem more and more acute and much more complex. This actually led a lot of people moving from villages towards the urban areas. So mass migration from the rural areas is another major impact of industrialization. Depletion of natural resources. Due to industrialization, there is constant depletion of natural resources. Many industries are powered by thermal power plants that consumes coal. Since large industries are spread over many acres of land, the agricultural land and forest are often cleared to make available the required land, right? And that's why today we have depletion of natural resources. What should be done is that these natural resources should be conserved, but because of industrialization, they are going in for, you know, cutting and clearing of agricultural land and forest, right? So this in turn will have a very, very adverse effect on the environment and on the ecosystem, right? So there are a lot of disadvantages of clearing these forests and clearing these agricultural land. So first and foremost is that, you know, the lot of floods which are expected and lot of landslides which are expected if we clear the forest and agricultural land. So in order to avoid these natural disasters, the forest has to be conserved, the agricultural land is to be conserved. Now next is because of industrialization. Now, because of growth in the population, large number of forests were being cleared. So deforestation took place. This led to loss of natural habitat. Another major impact is that because if we cut down the trees, then trees are the ones which act as natural purifiers because they take in the carbon dioxide and they give out the oxygen. So loss of oxygen producers and obviously CO2 eliminators. Right, so this is generally affecting our ecosystem. Next, a major impact is pollution. And when I say pollution, it is air pollution, land pollution, noise pollution, soil pollution, and all kinds of pollution. Because we have large industries which are getting deployed. So these industries, you know, emit very harmful gases into the environment, and the introduction of these harmful chemicals into air, this leads to air pollution. The noises that it produces also leads to noise pollution, and with this noise pollution we also have air pollution and land pollution. And so this air is exactly what we are breathing, and when we breathe this, then we also have harmful effects over our body. Next is increase of warlike situation. It's very clear that today almost all the countries are in that developing phase. They are equipped with the highly sophisticated weapons and machineries. And so there's a lot of competition among these countries. And this generally gives rise to this warlike situation between the two neighboring countries. Right, so this increase in warlike situation is another negative impact which the industrialization have brought in. Now let's also talk about synthetic materials. So we talked about population, we talked about industrialization. Now let's also talk about synthetic material, and the study of synthetic material is important because in today's world, the synthetic material have occupied a very, very important place in the textile industry. Let's study what is synthetic material, what are the advantages of synthetic material, what are the disadvantages of synthetic material, and how are these synthetic material affecting the environment. So now in our daily lives, if you see the clothes that we wear, you can see the jacket here, the clothes that we wear. So this is made up of synthetic fibers. The frame of the glass that we wear, that is also made up of a fiber. The PVC pipes that we use for the construction of our houses, so those are also fibers. The bottles, the water bottles that we use, the parachutes, the threads of these parachutes, and even the parachute material, that is made up of fibers. So there, everything that we use today is made up of synthetic fibers. Synthetic fiber is a part of our life today. From cell phones to computers to bicycle to the helmets and to any kind of plastic carry bags that we use today, the synthetic fibers have actually molded our society in many ways. You know, we have synthetic clothes also. You see here, this is a cell phone, these are the ropes. So even the clothes that we wear, even they are made up of synthetic fiber. In one sense, they have made our lives so easy. These things are so cheap to buy and so easy to use. But these synthetic materials have also left a very, very harmful imprints on our environment and perhaps the human health also. According to a new compilation of articles which is authorized by scientists around the world, they say that the synthetic fibers are actually polluting the environment, you know, because these synthetic fibers are non-biodegradable. We're going to talk about these synthetic fibers and also in general about plastic, right? Now, what are synthetic fibers? Synthetic fibers are fibers that are made by joining the monomers into polymers through a very, very complex process which is known as the polymerization. So polymerization is actually the process by which synthetic materials are created. What happens is there are monomers which are combined together and then they become polymers. So it's like this, you know, it's a chain of monomers. The process requires very, very small molecules that can combine chemically to another molecule and it can form a polymer chain or a 3D network of polymer, right? So that's what is called as synthetic material. Okay, these synthetic fabric includes, you know, examples are like polyester, ozone, acrylic, neon, nylon, rayon, acetate. So these are the examples of synthetic material. Now, chemicals that are used to make these synthetic fabrics, it comes from the petrochemical, which includes the sodium hydroxide and the carbon disulfide. These two things, that is the carbon hydroxide and the carbon disulfide, they are derived from coal, from oil, and from natural gas. So basically, they are petrochemicals, right? Synthetic fabrics are those textiles which are basically not grown, but they are man-made. You know, they are made in the laboratories. They are produced in the laboratories rather than natural fibers. Natural fibers are those which are actually produced naturally, like, you know, cotton and wool and all that. But synthetic fibers are those which are obtained, which are produced in the laboratory, right? These are developed by the lab technicians. So this is one chain of monomers, which is like this, and it forms a polymer then. So this is what is a synthetic fiber. And these synthetic fibers are basically new inventions. And prior to World War II, the clothing were all made up natural fibers. And the development of synthetic fiber rose because of necessity during World War. So a total of 70% of these fabric production in the world includes the synthetic fiber production. But there are many negative impacts on the body of people who wear these synthetic fibers. 8,000 carcinogenic chemicals are used to make these products. And these products basically come from very non-renewable resources, and these resources are generally non-biodegradable. And because they are non-biodegradable, these actually pollute the land, they pollute water, air, and also the wildlife. And also the major problem for these synthetic fibers, because they are non-biodegradable, is how do we recycle them? Recycling these synthetic material is another big issue. A large percentage of these material which is synthetic cannot be recycled. So that is the main issue. So then now the question which arises is that why do we use so much of synthetic fibers? Why do we need synthetic fibers? And before we answer these questions, let us first have a look at what are the various synthetic fabrics that are available. So the man-made synthetic fibers are like nylon. You must have seen the nylon ropes, the polyester. This is basically a fabric, a cloth fabric, acrylic, and lycra. Lycra is also a fabric from which the clothes are made. So these are various, you know, synthetic fabrics which people do wear on their body. So now, why do we use these synthetic fabrics? We use these synthetic fabrics because synthetic fabrics do not depend either on an agricultural crop or any animal farming. That is, these can be artificially produced in a laboratory. These can be created in a laboratory. We do not need any kind of natural product in order to create these synthetic fabrics. Secondly, these are generally very, very cheaper because they are artificially produced, because they are created in a laboratory and they do not come from any natural fiber. Generally, natural fibers will be very, very costly. Like you have seen, you know, generally cotton fabrics and khadi. So these types of fabric come from the nature, that is from the natural fiber. But that's why these are very costly. But synthetic fibers are generally very, very cheap. Next, synthetic fibers possess unique characteristics which make them very, very popular dress material because they are cheap, they are available, they can be produced in large quantity, and that's why they are so popular. They also dry up very quickly and they are durable. That is, they last for long as compared to any fabric which comes from nature. And they are readily available and also they are easy to maintain. So these are few advantages which are available with the synthetic fabrics, and that's why they are so popular. So even if we have so many negative impacts of these synthetic fibers, but it is still so popular among people. Few other examples are that these synthetic fibers are very, very less expensive because they are available in plenty. Next is they are durable, as we just discussed. These synthetic fibers are very, very strong and elastic. That is, they last for long, unlike the other fibers which are naturally produced. And they are easy to maintain and easily available. So these are few additional advantages of synthetic fibers. Now, but as I said that these synthetic fibers do have some negative impact on the people, on the population, and also on the wildlife, and finally the ecosystem. And these are the negative impacts. The marine turtles, they become entangled in discarded nets, and they were found dead with plastic garbage bag inside their stomach. So likewise, many other marine life is seen to have really a negative impact on them. Some marine mammals swallow plastic bags which, you know, resemble jellyfish in a seawater. The marine animals, they get confused between, you know, whether it is a plastic or whether it is a jellyfish or small fish, and they try to swallow it, and that's how, you know, they may die. Also, it is seen that about 44% of seabirds eat plastic, mistaken as food, which leads to suffocation and blockage of digestive tract, and eventually it leads to their death, right? So this is one of the negative impact on the marine environment. Plastic also is another synthetic material, synthetic fiber, and plastic actually harms the environment a lot. That is because they create a lot of pollution, and plastics are actually again non-biodegradable. It is very, very difficult to recycle them, to use them again. Also, the chemicals that are added to plastics are absorbed by human body. Some of these compounds have been found to even alter the hormones, and they have very, very negative impact on the human health also, right? Plastic debris laced with chemicals, and often, you know, it is injected by marine animals, and this can cause injury to the marine animals. Even the floating plastic waste, which can survive for thousands of years in water, it serves as mini transportation device for invasive species, which disrupts the habitat. Another disadvantages of plastic are that, you know, plastic buried deep in the landfills can also leach very, very harmful chemicals that eventually spread into the groundwater. There are many studies which suggest that about 4% of water oil production is used as a feedstock to make plastics, and a similar amount is consumed as energy in this process. Also, people are exposed to chemicals from the plastic multiple times a day, and through the air and dust and water and food. And also we see that these days we also are getting in touch with plastic, because the use of plastic in our daily lives is so much that we are almost unable to avoid plastic. But as we have just seen that plastic, the chemicals bring in such harmful effects in the body that, you know, we must avoid plastic. Some of the other disadvantages of synthetic fibers are that it shrinks and melts. So whenever the fiber is brought very, very close to any kind of fire, then it immediately shrinks and it melts and it sticks to the body. And that's why we always avoid wearing such synthetic fibers during many festivals, like especially Diwali. So whenever we are bursting any crackers, we should wear cotton clothes and not synthetic clothes, right? Another disadvantage is that the synthetic fabric do not absorb sweat, right? If you're wearing cotton, which is from a natural fiber, then cotton absorbs a lot of sweat. But on the other hand, the synthetic fibers, they do not absorb sweat, right? These synthetic fibers are generally very, very less comfortable when we wear them. And also the production is not environment friendly, because these synthetic fibers cannot be recycled. There's a major problem when it comes to recycling the synthetic fibers. So these are some of the disadvantages of synthetic fibers. Now, what is the solution of these synthetic fibers? What should we do? First and foremost is the most favored option is to reduce the use of these synthetic fibers. Second is reuse them. That is using the material repeatedly. That is, if you're using synthetic fibers, try to use the same synthetic fibers again and again rather than going for a new synthetic fiber. You can take an example of plastic, right? Any plastic bag, let's say. So first is, we have to reduce the use of plastic bag. Whenever it is required, we should most likely use any paper bag, right? Or any bag which is made up of cloth. Secondly, reuse them. Even if you're using a plastic bag, try to use that plastic bag again and again. So generally what do? Is we go to the vegetable shop, we buy vegetables and we take the plastic bag. We throw that plastic bag in the waste, in the dustbin. And again, the next time we go to the vegetable shop and we ask for a new plastic bag. So this should be avoided. It is preferred that the same plastic bag should be used again and again so as to avoid any kind of waste, right? Thirdly, recycle. That is using the materials to make new products. That is, if we have some extra plastic bags or extra plastic bottles at our place, so please do not throw them. Try to use these plastic bottles in your gardens. Try to use the plastic bag in some or the other way in the house so that it can be recycled. Next is recovery. That is recovering the energy from the waste. You must have seen that today the government is doing so much about waste management. That is the waste that they collect. They're trying to recycle that waste, right? Trying to use that waste in some or the other way. That's why we separate our waste. That is, the wet waste and the dry waste are separated. But that is because they want to recycle, reuse and recover some kind of energy from that waste. Lastly, landfills. That is, safe disposal of waste to landfills. Waste that we are throwing, that has to be properly disposed. So these reduce, reuse, recycle, recover and landfill, that is proper disposal of waste. These are some solutions by which actually we can avoid either using the synthetic fibers. And specifically, I've given you an example of plastic because plastics is something that we keep using in our daily lives, right? But it applies to even the synthetic fibers also, right? As far as possible, we should try and use fibers that are produced naturally, like cotton fiber or, you know, wool that is produced from natural fibers. Ways to recycle, refuse and reduce. Now, how should we reduce, reuse and recycle? So the three R's, right? Recycle aluminium cans and plastic bottles around your house. So how can you use these aluminium bottles and plastic bottles? You can use them in your gardening. You can decorate your home by using those plastic bottles and not throw it in the dustbin. Few other examples are like use the glass plate instead of wasting the paper plate. Also try to eat all the food that you make. So that is again another kind of wastage, you know, wastage of food. Buy a washing machine that doesn't require a lot of water. So these are basically the ways to conserve the resources, right? Whether it is a plastic, whether it is water, whether it is food, whether it is any waste. So the proper waste management should come into practice. Now, what are the benefits of recycle? Why are we only talking about reuse, recycle, reduce? What are the benefits of recycling? Why should we recycle the resources, or why should we recycle the fabrics? Because recycling reduces the need for landfillings and incineration. Secondly, it prevents pollution. Yes, because there is no waste. It also saves energy. Recycling decreases emission of greenhouse gases that contribute to global climate change. And this is how, in a way, indirectly, we are conserving our ecosystem. We are preventing our environment from getting polluted. So recycling also conserves the natural resources, because here we are only emphasizing on reuse, reduce, recycle, all these measures to conserve the natural resources. Finally, recycling helps to sustain the environment for our future generation. So this is how recycling, reduce, reuse, it helps us to conserve our ecosystem. It helps us to maintain our environment, pollution-free environment. So I hope you must have understood the concept of synthetic fibers, as well as, you know, how industrialization affects the environment, how industrialization and synthetic fiber affects our ecosystem, and also have harmful effect on the human population. So thank you for watching Edupedia World videos.